See, here's a partially candlelit vlog. That's a Halloween spooky story. And have to forgive my voice. I'm recovering from a bit of a cold. This story I had written in April 1999. And this was not too long after we had moved in. Actually, I have to correct myself. April of 99 is when we moved into the house in central New York. And so this would have been October. This would have been 6 months later. And I wrote the story to send to one of the local newspapers, a seasonal story, and also maybe a bit of an introduction for me as a writer being in the area. However, they never used the story. So I am going to use it now. There's a cold certainty to the whisper of an angel. Here in the county of Onondaga, as autumn wraps ever tighter around us, the silent fields of stone which identify the residents of our cemeteries become emblazoned by the reds, yellows, and browns of fallen, life-drained leaves. Soon, barren trees will clutch upward at the sky like withered, skeletal hands. Soon, there will be nothing between us and the endless snow. It has been this way since the Mohawk and Seneca roamed the hills. They spoke with animals long dead, spoke with ancestors, had a closer communion with nature than we can understand. Yet, even then, before England, France, and the Dutch had begun to colonize these untamed shores, autumn. Autumn itself whispered to the land like a cold and certain angel. A farmer named Elton Wilmeyer was the first victim, some say. He and his wife and his children were among the original settlers of what we now call Onondaga County. Their life was hard, complicated only by the rugged tasks of survival which filled most every hour of their day. It was not uncommon for Elton's hounds to bleed. It was not uncommon for Elton's hands to bleed from working the land. And this is how it started. On a rainy night, late October, as the Wilmeyer family slept restlessly, Elton's wife, Elaine, heard a deep, muffled scratching sound from somewhere outside. She told her husband, who put on his worn leather boots and lit a lantern. Proceeding cautiously toward the door of the farmhouse, Elton's mind raced with thoughts of an Indian attack or possibly a large animal trapped somewhere in the barn. He grabbed a crude wooden club and opened the door. The darkness of the land was near absolute as rain fell upon the leaf-strewn grass. And then, from a spot just beyond the barn, Elton heard the scratching again, this time a little louder. When he realized where it came from, Elton felt the hairs on the back of his neck rise. For off behind the barn, in a small and crude plot, were the buried remains of farm animals who had been butchered to provide fresh meat. Their bones were moving beneath the soil, reaching for the surface. Some reports state a meteor was seen that very same night, burning through the rain clouds. It might be why Elton Wilmeyer's house and barn were burned to the ground by dawn. But it also might not. His wife and children managed to escape the fire, but when they returned the next day to look for Elton, no trace of him could be found. And in the back of the barn was a patch of upturned earth devoid of the bones which had been interred there. Anybody might still be able to locate the remains of Elton Wilmire, for the precise location of his farmland has been lost to history. But if you happen to find yourself on the same ground this October, when the cold autumn whispers to you, as it did to Elton Wilmire, the idea of anybody becomes forever. And in the coming years, perhaps, people might search for your own remains. Happy Halloween, everybody.